SelectMany is one of the four core link operators. The world wouldn't be the same without it. Yet sometimes, just sometimes, the liberal use of enumerators required by SelectMany might hurt your application's performance. I will now show you how that happens and what you can do instead of using SelectMany if and when its use would impede the performance. I will use LINQ to analyze the text of Herman Melville's book The Whale, aka Moby Dick. This is the full text of the book obtained from Project Gutenberg. Let's put LINQ on the task of reading that book and you will quickly see where the danger lies. I will start by reading the paragraphs from the book. The book itself is an embedded resource, which I will read using a helper method. This would give us a sequence of strings with book paragraphs. Trim the lines, return the non-empty ones. So far it was easy. We didn't need a SelectMany for this. Let's spice it up by extracting individual words from all paragraphs. I will use a regular expression for that. This expression identifies word boundaries to isolate a word consisting of one or more Unicode characters. I already see SelectMany rearing its head. We start by reading the paragraphs, obtaining a sequence of strings, then apply the matches method of the regular expression to extract all individual word matches. The problem is that this expression returns an innumerable of match. That is not what we need. We need just a sequence of matches, each match carrying one word. Enter SelectMany, the unique link operator which flattens a nested sequence of sequences. Unpack each match object into a string it captured. The resulting sequence is all the words in the book. You can already start thinking about the performance of SelectMany in this example. Try to compare it to iterating through the match collection using for each. We shall measure that in this video. I'm calling these two methods to collect paragraphs and words into two lists. When I run the application, you will see that there are roughly 2500 paragraphs in the book and almost 215,000 words. These words I plan to process further. That will ultimately lead us to a revelation regarding the SelectMany operator, which you might not like and will seek a way to avoid. The request is to extract capital letters from the beginning of all words and to count the appearances of each. This regex pattern matches the beginning of the string followed by a capital Unicode letter. Then comes the LINQ expression. Turn each word into a match object. This will give us a sequence of matches. Filter out unsuccessful matches to obtain the sequence of successful match objects. Select the values. This will be the sequence of capital letters. Then use the new COUNTBY LINQ method, which returns a sequence of key value pairs. Convert each pair into a tuple. Notice that this expression required no SelectMany. That is the best case if you can make it that way. Avoid using SelectMany if you can. But I'm just about to complicate matters and make the use of SelectMany inevitable. Imagine you don't know how to extract the values you must count. This new method would require a selector function. I called it optional because some words might not contain the values we are looking for. It would be a delegate taking a word and returning the value it found in it. However, the value might not be there. Worse yet, some words will contain more than one value to count. The delegate would therefore return an array with the values it extracted from the word. Let's implement the new LINQ expression then. We may select the values returned by the selector function, but that would be wrong. The result would be a sequence of arrays of strings. We need just a sequence of extracted strings. Welcome SelectMany, which will flatten these arrays out and return just a sequence of successful matches. We find ourselves at the same place where we were below after isolating successful regex matches. So the rest of the expression will go the same. The difference is that this method is now configurable. It is a powerful, extendable method that can serve in various scenarios. I will show you two such scenarios. Identifying and counting the initial capital letters would start with the same regex you saw earlier. A concrete selector would check the word against the pattern and, if successful, return the matched value in a new array. Alternatively, return an empty array. We count the occurrences of capital letters by passing in the words and a concrete selector and collecting the results into a list. The true power becomes visible when we supply a different selector. The new regex matches any Unicode capital letter anywhere inside the words. The new selector might return multiple letters from a single word. If I supplied this selector instead, I would get the statistics for all capital letters in the book. This level of flexibility is great, and I achieved it by using SelectMany. Still, a benchmark would show that SelectMany also incurs a performance penalty. The reason is that SelectMany will iterate the results of each call to the selector delegate. Since there are over 200,000 words in the sequence, there will be 200,000 new enumerators, none of which were ever created in the method below. Still, this method is adding features we didn't have before. You will often have to choose between flexibility and performance. But what if you need both? I will now show you the third implementation which combines the best of both worlds. You have been familiar with this coding pattern since the inception of .NET. The task is to collect all matches of a pattern in a string. The option is to collect them into a string builder supplied by the caller. It is also common to return this string builder for further chaining. Iterate from matches without constructing an additional enumerator and append every new string to the end of the string builder. Applying this process to a sequence is equally simple. Start by turning this method into a strategy. Then use it to aggregate the results over all the strings in a long sequence. The aggregation starts from a single string builder, applying the strategy to all intermediate results before extracting the resulting string. Coding patterns based on string builder have been a part of .NET since version 1.0. You will now learn how to generalize this pattern to apply it to your own data when you need high performance. And if you like what you have seen so far, please consider joining the growing community on my Patreon page. This channel is free thanks to the donations made by patrons. As a patron, you get access to the source code of all videos on my channel, as well as additional materials not available on YouTube. You will find relevant links in the description. Let me now show you that same design applied to counting substrings. The new counting method would look similar, only requiring a different strategy. This delegate puts part of the burden on the caller. It would receive a dictionary, which associates substrings with the counts of their appearances. It also receives the word to process. The concrete delegate must return the same dictionary, possibly with some of the counts updated, to reflect the results of processing the current word. This is a shift in the strategy, as you can see. We expect the caller to cooperate in aggregating the counts. That may look like a bad design, but it is good for performance. The rest of the implementation is trivial. Aggregate all the words into a dictionary by iteratively applying the counting strategy. The dictionary would eventually contain the counts of all substrings extracted from all the words. Take all key-value pairs, turn them into tuples, and the method is complete. This design has lost some elegance and even some safety, as its correctness now depends on how the caller has implemented the strategy. Yet, as I promised, there will be a significant impact on performance. Let me show you how you can use this method now. A concrete strategy receives the dictionary and the word and returns the same dictionary. Its implementation will be procedural, and that already looks promising if we seek performance. Try to match the initial capital letter. If successful, retrieve the existing count for that letter or zero if this is the first appearance. Add one to it and overwrite the value in the dictionary. Then return the dictionary. The selecting strategy below may be easier to understand because it is an expression. This strategy has more details, but it promises better performance because it avoids creating 200,000 new enumerators. Nevertheless, both are equally simple to use. Call the counting method and pass it the desired strategy. Collect the counts into the list. The consumer will notice nothing special except the performance, which I will finally measure now. I have added a simple utility to quickly estimate running times. I don't need a full benchmark to prove my point here. If each call to SelectMany returned many objects, the cost of creating a new lazy evaluated enumerator would amortize across many objects. But in this use case here, we have 200,000 words, most of which produce zero items for the sequence. The cost of creating 200,000 enumerators will show up in the benchmark. Let's check out these flash estimates. The numbers will tell it all. The first experiment will measure the method with the selector. The second line will measure the performance of the method that collects results into a dictionary. I'm running the benchmark and the numbers are coming in. The implementation using the dictionary takes roughly one-third less time. That is a significant improvement. But this result is a tricky one. It doesn't tell the whole story. You will notice that any method includes matching the regex. I should exclude the time of that operation to compare SelectMany to the dictionary. This is an empty strategy which only pays the cost of matching the regular expression. I want to compare all three solutions now. Let's run the application to see the new times. The numbers are coming, and they shed a completely different light on how SelectMany impacts the running speed of your code. A great deal of the time was spent on calling the strategy and matching the regular expression. We should take that time out of the equation to see the real costs. Now we see it. Collecting the objects with SelectMany took 2.5 times more time than the dictionary in this use case. It could be 7 times as slow in a different example or just 2 times as slow, but I don't think it will ever come close to the speed of the dictionary. It's easy to draw a conclusion now. If you need speed, go to the straightforward solution first. If you need flexibility, go for the general solution that might include SelectMany. And if you need both speed and flexibility, then recall your school days and change the algorithm to exclude the use of SelectMany.